Well, hello there, all you amazing people. We are going to talk about Windows while it's starting up here and how I managed to be the crazy guy that ran Windows nonstop for over 7 years. No reinstall, 3 motherboards, 2 CPUs, and 3 or 2 graphic cards later. How did I manage to do that? I'm going to show you guys and girls what I did. This is a VM, but you can kind of get the idea here. And I didn't do much. I didn't spend hours and hours on tinkering and stuff like that. So first of all, let's just look what I have installed. I have this rounded corner here, but I don't have any antivirus. I do recommend you getting a antivirus. Just ease of mind, take a free one. They are well good enough combined with Windows Defender. If it's a system that you're running 24/7 at home, you know, with parents around or other people, if you're the only one using the computer, you can actually get away with only using Windows Defender. Another thing I recommend you to do, other than having an antivirus, is getting some form of malware protection. I like to use malware bytes. Again, this is also depending on how often you use your computer. Malware byte words. I've used this for over 10 years, I think now. I have this installed on my physical machine. I don't have it installed on this one here because this is my testing machine. Well, it's not my test machine. It's my recording coding VM. So I don't go out and look at crazy shit and click on everything and, you know. I'm not that adventurous with my habits on this one here. So you don't really need this one. But it's a good thing to have if you're running your system 24/7 and if you were on thousands of different sites doing, you know, a month or a week and stuff like that. It could be a really good idea to have. Then use some form of registry cleaner. So what is it called? CC cleaner. There you go. This one here. It had a little bit of iffy-diffiness over the past, but you don't have to use this one. Just use one reputable registry cleaner and then use those two. Use the malware one times a week. Use the registry cleaner one times a week. Set up the antivirus to scan once a day when you're not when you are asleep or you're not at home, or do a full scan every Sunday or something. Like, I did it every Sunday. I did a full blown scan. I did a registry cleaner. I did a malware cleaner. The other thing I did was I just used disk cleanup. There's probably some cleaning up here, and you have to remember this one here: clean up system files, and then clean up old Windows backups or updates. So if you do that, you can't roll back. You can see you're actually saving a lot of money. You're saving a lot of space, and you can go in here and you can, you know, select what you want to select. So what do we have here? Delivery optimization files is also someone that can get really, really big. Temporary files could be a good one to move also, and then you just clean that little bad boy up. So while that's doing this in the background, we can have it up here. I had one other program that I used I forgot one thing. Revo uninstaller. I forgot that one. My mistake. These are all the things I did. I did have a third party also disk cleaner that cleaned up a little bit more, but I found it somewhat useful. So I ran this disk cleaner first, and then the other one found maybe 50 megabytes more or something like that. You could use, you know, a third party disk cleaner just to get an ease of mind. But I will recommend some form of registry cleaner and look into which one of the best ones, because some of them are not really that good. That's all I did. That's it. I didn't do anything else. Once a week, a disk cleaning. Remove temporary shit. Had an antivirus to scan. It did like a fast scan every night, and then the night to Sunday, it will do a full scan, basically. I didn't fiddle with third-party scripts, optimizing this, disable, you know, services that, and all of that shit. I think the only service I disabled was when I was using Windows 10 the first 6 months. I disabled Game Bar because that will slow down your games. When they fixed it, I enabled Game Bar again, or Xbox, whatever the fuck it's called. If I got a new graphic card, I was using the, what is it called, DDU uninstaller, display driver, this one here. If I went from, let's say, Nvidia to AMD, which I did, I used this one here to uninstall the old drivers. And when I went from AMD back to Nvidia, I used this one again. When I went from Nvidia to Intel, I used this one again. And I installed it when Windows 10 came out, so I had it from Windows 10 all the way up till 2 months ago. All of these, like, 7-ish years of running Windows. And think about this. I run Windows. The only time I reboot Windows is if there is a Windows update. Or back in the day, like from 2015 to 2019, if I needed to boot into Linux and run Linux on my bare metal. Other than that, I did not reboot Windows. I had it running for 10, 15, 20, 30 days nonstop. No issue whatsoever. None. Could not feel it whatsoever. I'm running this new machine having a Ryzen 5 7000 series. Doing the same shit. Doing all of these things here. Revo uninstaller, CCDiner, Malwarebyte, antivirus. If I'm going back to Nvidia or AMD, I'm going to use this one here. It's that simple. See you all later. Bye bye.